Yeah, so Jordan and I met when we were in fifth and sixth grade, and it was actually at a cross country meet, and this was before I started running. And Jordan heard about me from a mutual friend, and so he was like, "Who's this Kylee person?" And then he sees me coming into this meet, and I came to their team tent. And I honestly don't remember meeting him then.
So anyway, I had known of Kylee Thacker through another mutual friend. So I knew, I heard of her, it wasn't the same guy, but I knew who she was, and then all of a sudden, she shows up at this cross-country meet, and that was the moment when I put her name to her face.
So the same mutual friend, I asked him to ask Jordan if he would go to the movies with me and a group of people. And it wasn't like a very formal date because I was in seventh grade. But Jordan told this mutual friend no, but the mutual friend didn't want to hurt my feelings, so the mutual friend told me yes. And so I remember just being so excited, and I was like prepping for this little date, right? And then I was like, oh, I have to call Jordan to confirm plans because I was a seventh grade weird person and decided that I needed to call him.
As a middle schooler, called to confirm plans. And so, who does that in middle school? Kylee Thacker does that in middle school. And so she called, and my mom picked up the phone, and Kylee, I'm sure, said, you know, "Hi, Kelly, this is Kylee, is Jordan around?" And my mom said, "Sure," and handed me the phone. And
there, and so she gave the phone to Jordan, and Jordan answers the phone, and I was like, "Hi, Jordan, it's Kylee, just calling to confirm plans for tonight." And he, no joke, heavy sighs on the phone, so he goes, "Kylee," and then breaks my little middle school heart.
I don't think I heavy sighed at all. In fact, I'm pretty sure I didn't. But she remembers that I heavy sighed. I just a huge heavy sigh on the telephone. And I broke her little middle school heart. And I will never live it down.
Fast forward to 2015, and Jordan messages me on Facebook and asks me if I want to catch up, and I was just like, "Oh, okay, sure, I'll catch up," and thinking it was just like two friends catching up. He never asked me for a date, he just asked to catch up.
2 years later, when I reached back out to her and asked her if she wanted to catch up, I should have used the "do you want to go on a date" instead, but I didn't, and so she obliged and said, "Sure, let's get together." And so later in May of 2015, we got together.
And so whenever we went on this catch-up date, or whatever you want to call it, I didn't realize it was a date until about two-thirds of the way through.
And I knew that I wanted it to be a date. That was my intention. I should have made that clear from the get-go. But it was probably until about halfway through our first date that Kylee realized that it was actually a date. And so that was my bad, I guess. So
sat there in Dairy Queen parking lot in Brazil, Indiana, and talked life. And I remember leaving, and I called my friend, and of course she was asleep. And I just left her message like, "Oh my gosh, like I think that went really well, but I don't really know what to think." And then the next day I woke up, and I knew it was different whenever I woke up and I said to myself, "Man, I'm bummed I don't get to hang out with him today."
I guess the rest is history after that. And so from that day forward, we've talked to each other every day since then, and that was the best decision I've ever made.
Jordan and I both got saved at a young age, and so throughout our whole lives we just kept like pursuing God and who He had for us, but ultimately who He wanted us to be when we met or started dating our future spouse. And so Jordan and I even continue now, we do Bible studies together and we pray together, and we definitely feel like the triangle where the closer you get to God, the closer you get to each other. And so we really believe that like we can't fully love each other and have fully like the marriage God wants for us without pursuing it.
Obviously, Kylee and I have spent a lot of time praying about each other, for each other. Even before we knew each other, you know, we were praying for God to put the right people in our lives. I have no doubt in my mind that God put Kylee and I together for a reason. He's crossed our paths in the way he did on purpose, and she is my biggest blessing. Absolutely, hands down, my biggest blessing in life. And so, and even now that we're together, we continue to, you know, pray with each other, and we believe that God has a purpose for our lives, and that he ultimately knows what's best for us, and you know, the decisions we make are all based on that firm foundation of God at the center. And so I truly believe that when I love God, I can love Kylee the best. And so that's the biggest priority in my relationship with Kylee, is to love God first. And that will ultimately, I believe, bring us closer together. And so that's how we've kind of structured our relationship. It's been awesome. And so, you know, God has worked wonders in our relationship in this short, you know, time that we have. And I am incredibly excited to see what God has for us.
You have a video of what?